Hello there, my name is Anand, and today I'll be showing off one of Cross the Road Electronics' newest products, the Talon Tach.
The Talon Tach is a multi-purpose pass-through limit switch and tachometer. It uses the small reflective sensor here and some signal conditioning to provide output signals with a 1 to 5 millimeter air gap between it and the sensing surface. The Talon Tach is designed to work with the Talon data port natively, but also features a general purpose interface through these three header pin holes. You can hook up a standard 3-pin PWM cable to these to use the Talon Tach any way you want. Furthermore, the three small solder pads here let you select the mode of operation when used with the Talon: reverse limit switch, forward limit switch, and tachometer. The back of the Talon Tach, as you can see, features two data port sockets. This lets you daisy chain the Talon Tach to other Talon Tachs, SRX mag encoders, or most other products that we sell.
Now, I've got a traditionally tricky control situation here. I have an arm controlled by my Versa Planetary and an integrated encoder, but I have no easy way of mounting limit switches to the ends of travel. This is where the Talon Tach comes in. I'll just mount one to either end of the motion, and I can connect them back to the Talon for easy limit switches. I'm using a few of our 12-inch Talon data cables to connect all this up. I'm also using these little 3D printed brackets that let me adjust the Talon Tach spacing on the fly. You can find files for these in STEP and STL formats on our website. And finally, I've taped over the unused pads of the Talon Tach with electrical tape to make sure that metal swarf doesn't short them by accident. Next, I'll bring the arm down and adjust the Talon Tach to be about 1/8 inch from the sensing surface. See the manual for more information on how far the Talon Tach should be. This mount has an adjustable target, so I don't need to move the tach when I'm adjusting it. And there we go! I've got this hero board programmed to use the motion magic feature of the Talon SRXs to control the position of this arm. Let's see if it works like it should. There's the limiting. More limiting. I'm using the Talon SRX.isSensorPresent function to check and see that the mag encoder is always connected. But if it were to become disconnected during a match, for example if a cable got pulled out, I've programmed the hero to tell the arm to just move via direct voltage but still use the limit switches. Let's see if this works. Using Talon Tach's limit switches is as easy as screwing things down to VersaFrame and hitting go. Aluminum and light plastic work just fine as reflective surfaces, but many others are possible as well. See the manual for more information on choosing the right reflective surface. Of course, the Talon Tach can also be used as a tachometer for high-speed applications like flywheels. Here, I've got an Andymark Skywheel driven by a SIM motor on a hex shaft. Normally, I would need to add an encoder to sense the speed of the flywheel, which can be time-consuming and expensive to mount. But with the Talon Tach, I can read the speed with just a single white mark on the side of the wheel.
I'm using this white gaffer's tape to make a wide mark on the side of the wheel. Be careful when using tape to mark wheels, as it can delaminate from the wheel at high speeds and cause the tach to lose readings. This tape is quite strong though, so I'm confident that it will hold up.
Now, I've set the hero to take the tach's returned pulse width and turn it into an RPM. See the manual for more information on how to accomplish that. Hopefully, this video gave you some ideas about how to use the Talon Tach in various ways. Thanks to the flexibility of the dual gadgeteer ports and selection solder pads, there's a lot of ways you can use the Talon Tach outside of what I've demoed here. See the manual for a full list of features. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.